Josh Pick. Good afternoon, everybody. Happy Thursday, Mosh Pit. Today is the 28th of December, 2023. What is up, Mosh Pit? How you doing? Good bloody evening to you, or afternoon, or morning, or night to you. I don't know. Wherever you're at. Hello, Mosh Pit. Good evening, everybody. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, happy new year. How you doing? Super excited tonight. We're going to be running it back with a Raid Shadow Legends stream, sponsor stream for the second segment of tonight. But first, we're going to start off with an Eden run, as always. For those of you who did not see or hear today's episode, of course, you probably don't know what's going on. But we're doing another sponsored segment, another sponsored stream for Raid Shadow Legends. They've got a new update that came out, and they enjoyed the first one so much earlier this month in December that we're going to be running it back. But they're also allowing me to play some Isaac in between there, so which is really cool of them. Looking forward to doing that. And yeah, we're just going to hop on in. I know that everyone has had has been having a day filled with Isaac, a day filled with video games, of course. Andrew Hacker, welcome to the Mosh Pit. Thank you for the YouTube MVP sub here. Enjoy those emotes. There's not enough. There ain't enough chatting going on. Let's see if we can spur up. We need some spam here. Spam it. Hello, Thornra, Dennis, Gotini, Razzly, Nathan, the Jeb, Limiting Zero, Arkan Ray, Arkan Ray, Jacob, Striker Cloud, Gen Z, Asus, Legendary Mr. Grimm, Thorna, Andrew, Major Prod, Pablos, Robin, hello, Uber Lord, Pepe, VK, Jay, Jared, Joe, Samantha. Thank you, Andrew. I appreciate that. Challenging myself some names? That ain't spam, Mosh Pit. That ain't no spam at all. Judging your team, hello, Jason. Hello, Ethan, Sequoias. A Russian name that I can't read. Jive, hello, Bogdan. Good evening, everybody. Looking forward to getting to Raid, but first let's hop on in some Isaac. You're gonna see the Twitch overlay, but obviously there's no Twitch overlay. Well, there's a Twitch overlay, but we're not on Twitch, obviously. And yeah, definitely go check it out if you wanted to get a double dose of Isaac today. You can of course switch off the live stream, go check out the daily stream or the daily run that we did today. It was a very, very cool run, yeah, we talked about the sponsor stream on that one. But first, we're going to be doing an Eden run. Let's hop on in. Just unlocked all the tainted characters last night. Well, good luck. is that a death certificate we see? We're starting with a death certificate, y'all. We got Jeb's minted. Okay. Well, then. It is truly a blessed day today. We have a death certificate start. Yeah, we will take that. I will take that. Now comes the biggest decision here. What do we get with a floor one death certificate? The wobbles. It is Mosh Pit blessed. People are saying rock bottom. Sacred Heart, Brimstone, Sacred Orb. See, I don't subscribe to the idea of getting Sacred Orb on the first if you have like first crack. You can't go wrong with Binge Eater. You really can't go wrong with Binge Eater. But I think that's too boring for a live stream. People are saying rock bottom 100%. Glitch Crown. I mean, Glitch Crown could be a possibility. Soy milk. I wish I could make a reliable poll. Let's see what we get from the boss, and then we'll go from there. TM trainer. No, we're saving that. We're saving that for the like streak goal. Okay, so there's absolutely nothing to do in the store. Got it. Missing no. What was that? Dude. The schmooves have been out of control lately. Okay, we got tears up. All right. Really? The secret room ain't there? Where in the world is the secret room then, game? Oh, I guess I should have known. Ah, it's right here. Oh, whatever. What do we do with a floor one death certificate mosh pit? Oh, Joshua. Take a meme item. Now, when have I ever been known to go with memes? Tractor beam? That would subvert a lot of expectations. Okay. The key is forever lost. A lot of people saying Sacred Orb. I don't subscribe to the Sacred Orb, like, theory. I really don't. Let's see how the run goes. I don't think I've ever had a floor one Sacred Orb. A lot of people are saying that Sacred Orb is just, like, obviously the earlier that you get it, the better. I don't believe that. So let's have this run prove to us why this is the convince me Sacred Orb isn't mid. It is the best moment to get it, is right at the beginning of the first floor. I mean, technically, I should have picked it up before even going into my item rooms and stuff, but let's see. This would be convince me that Sacred Orb isn't mid. This is the watershed moment for Sacred Orb. Yeah, see, Legend of Furore is saying exactly what we're all thinking. I've had Sacred Orb before, and never really seen that much of a difference. I mean, it does remove items, of course. I'm not saying that it's a bad item. I'm just saying it's mid. I think that it's overrated. That's all I'm saying. So this is the prove me wrong sacred orb about you. What is this pop-up that I'm seeing here? Ads will run shortly for some viewers. Skip ads. Yeah, no. No ads, YouTube. Thanks. That's a new one. Ready for it to go crazy now? Let's see. Look, I want it to go crazy for me, okay? Our movement speed's also kinda doo-doo. Lover's card, man. Yeah, I have YouTube Premium too. That's the way to go. Nothing but YouTube Premium. Bag of crafting. That's just super duper great. It's really great. Sacred Orb, off to a great start here. Thanks for the bag of crafting. I mean, I'd rather have the D20 than the bag of crafting. Sinvicta with basic movement speed, kind of trash, NGL. Now, are you saying that as an insult? You're saying that I play trashy with basic movement speed? Or are you saying that 0.99 is trash movement speed? Because it is. I'm pretty sure the Sacred Orb does not affect what you craft with the bag of crafting. Once I find a reliable source of high quality manufacturing options, I would do merch off of the website. Hello, Moldova. Thank you, Aurelius. No, I do not like bag of crafting at all, really. Lost Fly. It's 2 or 3 Beelzebub. No, you cannot get previews of merch that don't exist. There you go, got some movement speed. Where did trash movement speed? Where was it? 0.99, just basic movement speed, and you called it trash. It is trash. Now we don't have trash. .29 is acceptable. Oh, I know it doesn't. I know it doesn't synergize with it. I wish it did. I'm the first person to say your name correctly first try, Aurelius. It's like I always say, all streamers and YouTubers are stupid. All right, Sacred Orb looking real good. Thanks for the the compass and bag of crafting, and now lucky scab. Yeah. Okay. Looking real solid. Looking real solid. We were waiting for you, mozzarella pizza. We literally sat here and waited for 10 minutes for you. And you weren't here. You should be sorry for being late. Thank you, Kyle Crawford, for the $20 super chat. Sin, just want to keep thanking you for all the content and entertainment you provide us for all the years. Let's make next year amazing. If you're here, Kyle, it's going to be amazing. Even more amazinger. Thank you very much, Kyle. It's very generous of you for the $20. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas. Can't take this orb slander. If you want to not get orb slander, then your mid item better start producing some better items other than bag of crafting, magic scab, and friggin' number one. The double tinted rock right there. That's a double tinted rock right there. Look, all I'm saying, the sacred orb is overrated. And right now, I'm just saying it's proving that. Look, the facts don't lie. Hello, McCaden. I wouldn't say that it's a worse chaos. I think that's disingenuous. Is the Sinvicta like balancing out the sacred orb luck? What's going on over here? You guys get stuck on each other? Yeah, it checks out, Kevin. Yeah, super hyped today. I'm really, really looking forward to the Raid Shadow Legends part of the stream, of course. Got a lot of talking points. Got a lot of stuff. And also, I will admit, I've been free to play up until literally today because I didn't have any... I wanted to get some summons. I'm going to show off my account before we do, like, you know, the summons and everything and show what I've accomplished so far being totally free to play. But after today, technically, I'm no longer free to play. Mr. Dolly, again, another really basic boss upgrade that we've always gotten without Sacred Orb. And I didn't even have to use a death certificate for it. Oh, you're one of those P2W. Hey, tank firing Marmite. Did you not just hear what I said? Because I'm going to assume that you didn't. I'm going to show off what I've gotten as being totally free to play before we do our summons. My intent was to stay free to play. But at the same time, I also wanted some fun summons to do. It was sarcasm. You know what? That's Tank's fault. Guppy's head. I mean, it's better than bag of crafting. Orb gate. Now, who's to say that Sacred Orb didn't give us Guppy's head, right? And if this is a Sinvicta luck type thing where we're just simply getting we're getting balanced out by Sinvicta luck, and that's when people are like, oh, it's a sample pool, it's a sample size pool of one. I got you, Tank. I got you. My fault for misinterpreting your sarcasm. I take it back. But also, if I ever go after anyone in chat, just know that it's done out of pure hilarity and in good spirits. Never personal. You should try Lethal Company in the future. If only I had not done multiple videos on that game already on the gaming channel. Exposed. Caught in 4K.
This mid item is sending you. Yeah, sending you all the way to the regret barn. Happy early birthday, Chris Barber. So, again, Hysteria, I do not have any merch to show because I don't have any merch that exists right now. I have stuff on the Design by Human store, but I'm not going to promote them because I don't like them. Okay, Stairway, okay. Okay, you got my attention now. I didn't see that bomb there. The orb speaks. We get one good item. Redeemed! You know that, y'all know that that could have just been given to us by just simply the pool. Right? That could have just been given to us by the sacroom pool, right? Hello, Furious Anger. I mean, I hate on the Bucks too. Keeper's sack, baby. That's all sacred orb. It's not the first time I've gotten the Stairway from a sacroom payout, I'm just saying. Do we go for pentagram here? Okay. I tried for the one shot of the pentagram. It didn't work. Really? Ah, it's over there. Okay. We don't have enough money for the stairway. That was the risk trying to go for the pentagram. Was that we're kind of sacrificing. You know what? I'm not going to go in there. You know why? Here's why. Because if we go in there and there's something good, that somehow Sacred Orb has actually done something, we won't be able to get it, and it won't appear again. So I'm not going to go up into the ladder this time. Right. Sinvicta smart. Yes, there is a external information mod for Rebirth. You just have to be on PC to get it. There's no reason for us to go into the stairway store right now if we can't afford to buy anything. All we're doing is just exhausting the item pool. Yeah, cricket's leg. It's a literal cricket leg. And it just spawns random flies. It's not really that great. I mean, it's fine. Like, it's nice getting, like, the poison and the slowing fly is just kind of meh. Hey there, bud. Hey, everybody. Conehead. Hey, you know what? Thanks, Sacred Orb. Another very common item. Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate it. Have I tried Risk of Rain 2? I had a long-running series of Risk of Rain 2, actually. On this very YouTube channel. I haven't played it in years because I really don't like... I like Risk of Rain 2. The thing that I don't like about Risk of Rain 2 is the same thing I don't like about Risk of Rain, is that you can have all this time to set up this amazing, really cool build only for you to get yeeted in, like, less than a second by something that you didn't even see. Just because the game just ramps up to be too powerful. So Risk of Rain 2, it's a fun multiplayer experience, but with the amount of hours I sunk into that game, it got really frustrating to get really, really awesome builds and then just have the game just be like, all right, I win. This is a dead end. Hello, Colin. Oh, I'm looking forward to Monster Hunter Wilds, trust me. I reinstalled World the other day. Although I do think that Rise is better than World. I know that there's a huge campaign going on right now for Monster Hunter World. Yeah, no, Rise is just a better game in general than World was. I love World, don't get me wrong, but Rise just became better than World. Rise is more of a return to form and brings me back to, like, my portable days on Monster Hunter. World is great, don't get me wrong, but there's a lot of features that, like, are just kind of bloat when all you want to do is hunt monsters. Bomb's Pearls, another very common boss drop. Sacred Orb mid, confirmed. Immaculate Heart, again, common angel deal. Hello, Addy Bear, Merry Christmas. I'm looking forward to the new Godzilla Kong, although I will say that it's starting to get a little bit... Oh, Chris the XL, that's just super. That's real good. So not only do we lose an angel deal, we lose a... Lose a stairway shop. Got it. Oh, wow. Look at that. Vade Retro. Oh. Oh, got ourselves a great shop here. All right. I don't mind Immaculate Heart because it gives you a nice damage up. You just got to be careful with certain tier effects. And click the like button, everybody. Would love to see 1,000 likes on this live stream. Show support of the channel, and also as a big thank you to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring, allowing me to play Isaac, a game that they have nothing to do with before their actual game, which is really cool of them. Thank you very much, everyone. If you call Sacred Orb crap, it will not pay out. It needs words of encouragement. I never once did I say that Sacred Orb was crap. You can go back, rewind this YouTube live stream for the last 41 minutes and 13 seconds. Never once did I ever say that Sacred Orb was crap. I said it's mid, because it is. It's very mid. So hey, you know, Sacred Orb apologists out there, this is your run. I'm giving your item a chance to shine. No words of encouragement. Duke, welcome back to the Mosh Pit. Thank you very much for that YouTube membership. Might be Tuck. I'm pretty sure it's Duke, though. Euthanasia. Wow. Conehead prevented... Not only did Conehead prevent the damage... Ooh! Not only did Conehead prevent the damage going into the curse room, but also prevented it going out of the curse room. And one of the taps on the Demon Judgment. No, there won't be content for Dark Souls or Dead Cells. The orb calculates all. Blow Zach off. Love me some Tech 1. On a 90 game loss streak, it happens to the best of us. I cannot read that name, but welcome to the Mosh Pit. Thank you very much for the YouTube membership. If you can give me the English translation for that, I will say it. Unfortunately, Cyrillic is one of my... It's just a language that I just... I can't read. I wish I could fake it, but I can't. Am I convinced yet? We get Tech 1, all of a sudden Sacred Orb's not mid anymore. We've gotten more upgrades from Keeper Sack than we have from Sacred Orb. Just saying. JS, JS. FR, FR. On God, no cap. You give me another freaking blood bag before I get a significant amount of money game. Need to rerun the seed without Sacred Orb. See how it compares. We can do that for the second run after the raid segment, if I'm not too tired. Who gave you Keeper Sack? It was in the shop. It's a shop item. You don't get the Sacred Orb. Sacred Orb. Look, Sacred Orb people, you don't get to say, well, that was clearly because Sacred Orb. Because we happen to get an item that's always been in the same item pool that we got it in. That's not how this works. You don't get to have your cake and eat it too. Either it gives us better items than we would have ever gotten, or it doesn't. All right? Just because we got Keeper Sack in the shop while also having Sacred Orb does not tell me that Sacred Orb gave us Keeper Sack. No, that's not how it works. Patsyuk, which means rat in Russian. I think that's Russian. Apologies if it's not Russian. Thank you very much, Patsyuk. Can I just call you Pat? Why don't you use mods that add benefit to life? Quality of life, fast destroy poop, fast using beggars and donators. Because I don't like playing with mods. That modifies the game way, way, way too much. I don't like playing with mods in general. I don't like playing with the external information mod, but it's a necessary evil in this game at this point. Why does this feel like we're going in the wrong direction? As we are. All right. The only one I have on is the external information mod. That's the only mod that I play with. And the only reason why I even started playing with that mod was way back in, what, Afterbirth Plus? When YouTube was like, you know, it's a great teaching tool for new players. And I was like, I begrudgingly admitted that, sure. Because obviously I'm not going to have encyclopedic knowledge of every single item and know what every single, like, multiplier is or anything like that. So the external information mod just takes the chore out of alt-tabbing and going to Platinum God or the Wikipedia and looking up stuff, which is nice. I still don't like playing with mods, though. I think that... Something like that should exist in the game as a toggleable option, especially when it comes to bagger crafting. Syndicate, welcome to the Mosh Pit MVPs. Thank you for that YouTube sub. Blue cap. No cap, on God. Okay, we hit exactly with zero of those bombs. Gotta speed things up. You realize that we're already close to 5 o'clock already. We got 3 minutes to finish this run. The stream will be kept on YouTube, yes. Ukrainian. Oh, now I really feel bad. I apologize about that. Happy holidays. We gotta go, gotta go. There are some very talented mod makers out there, yes. Those angel shops are less than stellar, I would say. EJs, all right. I mean, I'm saying. Crawl space there. I'm probably going to have to pause this run. Because I've got to, we have to switch it. We have to switch at 5. So I'll finish off this floor and then we'll switch over to raid because that's when the sponsored tweet is going out. And I don't want to be late. Also, where do we go? You're telling me in order for us to go south, we have to go north. So for us to go, in order for us to go southeast, we gotta go dead south. Next angel shop's gonna be amazing because of Sacred Orb. Okay. So if it's not, then Dan Blackburn owes everyone a hearty Christmas ho ho ho. Yeah, I'm excited too because I get to do some pay to win summons. Dude, Conehead has prevented so much damage. And Major Prod is remembering. Why did that count as red heart damage? We had an eternal heart game. Oh, marbles. Okay. Thanks, Sacred Orb. Man, what an item. All right, here comes that last shop. And it's Angelic Prism. All right. Huge. All right, everyone. We're going to switch on over. I apologize for cutting short the Eden run, but we got to get to the sponsored segment of the stream. Don't worry. We're going to finish it. We're going to finish it, and we're going to go right back to Isaac after raid. But first, let me make sure that the tweet went out. I got to switch the old title and the game here onto YouTube's. So yeah, stick around, everyone. It's only going to be an hour. Only going to be an hour. Let's go mosh pit. I got to change the game name too. There we go. Raid Shadow Legends. All right, should be updated there. Bum, 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 bum. All right, Addy Bear, thank you very much for the 1 month sub here in the Mosh Pit MVPs. Welcome. Enjoy your new emotes. Limiting Zero is going to be your raid bot for the evening. Let me make sure that the tweet went out. It did go out. Awesome. 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 On God, no cap. Welcome, everyone, out to our second ever YouTube sponsored stream here. Once again, sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. They enjoyed the first run so much that we did earlier in December that they wanted to run it back. So I'm very, very grateful to them for allowing me to do another sponsored stream here on YouTube. It's literally the only ever sponsored stream I've ever done on YouTube. So it's really cool of them and super excited to be showing you exactly what's going on in Raid. Now, for those of you who watched my first Raid stream that we did earlier in December, you will know that I hadn't played in a while. You will know that I did not, like, I think my account level is like level 12 or something like that. Since then, I have played quite a bit. Since then, I have played quite a bit. That's what I will say. You can check out everybody if you want to. You can check out this QR code. Let me make sure that the make sure it's up. There we go. Yeah, go check it out for yourself. Lemming Zero will be posting every 10 minutes. You can go find a download link, or you can check the information description down below. And as you can see, I have literally played. This is no cap at all. I literally have played every single day since that stream. I'm on day 33. That's how long I've been playing. All right. So I've been playing a lot. Now, what I will say, and I said this during the Isaac segment, for those of you who skipped to the Isaac segment and you want to go check out Raid, I have not spent any money up until now. I have spent money for this stream to do some summons. I've got a lot of shards here. We're going to be doing every single one of these shards. I know that there's a 2x summoning event starting tomorrow, which doesn't line up with what I was going to be doing today, but that's okay. However, all my champions that I've gotten since the last time you saw me play, all of these were acquired free to play. Okay, my intent is to keep this account as free to play as possible for sponsored streams. I may make a pay to win one maybe later on. I don't know. But for right now, free to play is how I prefer to play these hero collector games, which is it's more fun for me because it feels like you earn a lot of stuff. So this is my main lineup here. Kale, of course, is my main starter. He's one of the starters heroes that you get when you start the game. You also have Berengiri, who is a very, very awesome looking hero. He's an epic. He was like the best epic that I've gotten so far. Again, free to play. War Maiden, she's very good at debuffing. She's very good at she can basically carry you through the entire game, and she's also free to farm as well, which is really cool. And I'll show everyone how to do that. Eris, I've built her, but I haven't used her yet. Again, this is another rare champion. She's farmable, very, very easy to acquire. I also have Armiger, who is a rare or an uncommon. He starts off as a 2-star. So, and then I also have Luria. I just got Taragi the Frog, who is a really, really awesome champion for Clan Boss, and he deals with poison, all that kind of good stuff. And then Haikatoon is a login character that you get after 1 month of playing the game. So as you see, I'm not BSing you. I've been playing the game since the last sponsor stream that we did. Oh yeah, and I also got the Golden Reaper, who I haven't built out yet because I don't know how to use her yet. So. But what is Raid? Those of you asking, what is this game? I've seen all the sponsored stuff. I've seen the memes. I've seen all the tweets, all the viral marketing campaign. What exactly is Raid Shadow Legends? Raid Shadow Legends is a hero collector RPG that you can play either on mobile devices or you can play on your desktop like I'm doing right now. It's totally cross-platform. You can play it on any device that you want. It runs flawlessly, seamlessly. And basically the goal is you're going to be putting together a team of heroes that you get by going to the portal and summoning these. It's totally random. It's very, very generous with rewards, very generous with shards. You can farm shards up to get a starter team going. They give you a free champion to begin with as well. And essentially you want to progress through the game, which is absolutely positively massive. As you see here, this is the latest content that they released this month called the Cursed City. I have not gone in there yet because I'm going to get absolutely destroyed. I'm still new to the game, but I have way more experience now than I did on the last couple of from the last sponsor stream. So I have gotten to nightmare difficulty, but there's four branching difficulties that you can go through the campaign. There's dungeons. The dungeons are where you're going to be farming all kinds of resources and artifacts, which is gear for your champions. Faction wars, this is going to be, these are basically targeted PvE wars where you can only take a certain type of hero that you have going up against another certain type of hero. It's more of like the mid-game area as far as like progression, so I wouldn't worry about faction wars. Arena, this is your classic PvP arena. There's PvP in the game. You basically go up against other people's arena teams and try to climb the ranks to get rewards, that sort of thing. The live arena is something that they just added not that long ago, which is literally live PvP. Other games have done this as well, where basically you ban other people's champions. You have your own champions. They have their own champions. Then you fight against each other live, which is really cool. It's like a live turn-based RPG. And then tag team arena is where you have multiple teams set up, and then you go up against other people's multiple teams. So it's like a big old battle royale kind of in a way. Doom Tower or clan bosses, this is where you're going to be mainly focusing in the early game. This is where you're going to be getting some of the best stuff in the game early on. We do have a clan as well, which is called the Mosh Pit, and you can check that one out. If you are in a game right now, it's called Official Mosh Pit. We're level 3. I am very, very stingy when it comes to purging inactive people. As you can see, everyone in the clan right now, everyone, except for this person who I think was just added, which, you know what? I'm just going to remove him. So we have one spot right now. But you can ask Limiting Zero. I'm very, very strict when it comes to keeping the clan healthy and active. No one is inactive for more than a day. Otherwise, they get the boot because we want people playing. So we do have an official clan in the game. And we have one spot right now. We're level 3, and we're very close to level 4. So, but I'll show you what the gameplay is like for Raid. And we'll just do a run. I was actually leveling up food right now when I was on before the stream started. So just to show you how the gameplay goes real quickly, let me go ahead and I'm just going to throw some food in here. There we go. All right. So I'm going to show you exactly how the game is played. I'm going to turn off auto mode and just show you. So this is your basic setup when it comes to Raid. You have your team here. It can be comprised all the way up to 6 members of a party, I believe, 5 or 6, something like that. And essentially, it's turn-based. So you all know how turn-based RPGs go. You can target which one you want, click on them, it does their basic attack. Or if you wanted to switch their moves like this, you could do so. Like this one buffs, this one does an AoE, as you can see. And this is just your basic attack. You can click and hold on moves if you want to get the full story of what they do. And we'll just use a basic attack here. So everything is beautifully animated. The art is always really, really good. I think the art's really underrated for a lot of assets that Raid does. You can put it on auto, which is where primarily you're going to be doing. You can do what's called manual, which is what we're doing right now. Obviously, it's just manual. Like, we can just AoE here. Kale getting some big-time plays, big-time damage. But generally speaking, you're going to be autoing. And this is where the computer just kind of takes over for you, and they all do their buffs. They all do. You can dictate exactly, you know, who does what. I'm gonna turn down the volume just a little bit because it looks like it's coming a little bit too hot. You can dictate about, you know, which hero does what. You can tell them to turn off a skill if you don't necessarily want them leading off with an AoE or a buff. You can also speed things up too. So x2 is generally the speed that I play. Just because as beautiful as the animation goes, time is everything in this game. You want to be maximizing what you can do with your time in the game. If you want to play serious, if you want to play casual, then it doesn't really matter. Play how you want. That's the nice thing about Raid. There you go. So at the end, you beat basically what is a level boss, and you get a variety of rewards here. This time we got an uncommon speed helmet, and these are called artifacts. I'm going to go ahead and show you what the artifacts are really quickly. So for those of you who are familiar with these type of games, you'll know that artifacts are gear. They all have a fixed stat, and then which is a main stat, and then they all have random stats, which are going to be the substats. So I'm going to show you what that is. So for weapons here, this stat right here, I don't know if you can see my mouse cursor. This one is attack. Your weapon is always going to have an attack for the main stat, and then the 3 substats are going to be completely random. They can be percentages, they can be flat rates, but the top 3, basically the top 3 slots in your character artifact gear are always going to be flat. Okay, and then the bottom 3, they can be flat, but you want them to be, except for speed, you want them to be percentage. So generally speaking, for basically like most of the champions in this game, what you can do is you really want to have crit rate for your gloves, and then HP for your chest piece. And we're talking about percentage, not flat rate. And then speed. Speed is the only flat stat that you want on the bottom layer here. And then you also have rings and banners and necklaces, which that's a little bit. I'm still early game, just to be clear. But like, this is something that you don't even have to worry about when you first get started. Yes, this video will stay up on YouTube after that. You can check the link in the description, everyone, or that link that Limiting Zero posted in the chat if you want to download Raid for yourself. So, but yeah, that's basically just the beginning of it. So that's the basics of Raid. You're putting together a team of heroes in any combination that you want. You're summoning them from shards, trying to get as much content as you can down to get bigger and better loot and make your team stronger, take down even tougher bosses, and eventually clearing the end game, which is going to take a long time. It takes a long time to get stuff done. That's why it's important to play very efficiently in this game. Oh, apparently my market's up as well. And yeah, I've been having, I've unironically been enjoying the game a lot more now that I know exactly how to play. Ever since we did that first sponsor stream. So, and they're not paying me to say that, by the way. Kevin says, how are the customizations? You can customize. There are certain builds that you can go through masteries here for every single champion in the game. They all have these masteries. They have offense, defense, support. Eventually you also get blessings, which I just unlocked, but I have not used them yet because I'm not quite sure how they work. These are the blessings here. Every single one of the champions in the game has this, I believe. At least all rares and above do. I don't know about uncommons. But yeah, this will tell you exactly what the blessings are. And the game is so deep, it's insane. Like, I never, when I first played Raid, and even when I did that first sponsor stream, I didn't understand exactly how deep that Raid went. And it goes real deep for those of you who are stat junkies out there. So this summer, Raid Shadow Legends is also premiered. This past summer, they premiered an awesome limited animated series called Call of the Arbiter, which you can find on the official Raid YouTube channel. I'll have Limbing Zero go ahead and post that. Actually, I might be able to copy it from here. Yeah, Call of the Arbiter, this one here. So you can, if you're in game, all you got to do is just click on the hamburger over here, and then go to Call of the Arbiter. You can watch these. If you watch all of them, you get free rewards in-game as well, which is really cool to help jumpstart your account. You can check out the QR code up here on the top right-hand side if you'd like to. And you also get some awesome rewards, by the way, for signing up. If you do sign up, if you do sign up and hit level 12, you get a variety of different rewards here, including the starter pack, which gives you a Drake, an epic champion that you can see right there. You get some energy, you get some skill books, you get an XP booster, all the value of $30. That's if you sign up with that link on Raid. And there's also a brand new website as well, dedicated to celebrating the winter event. The Christmas Story, which you can find out this December. You can revel in the festive spirit with Raid alongside of the Yuletide events. They're running a special promotion where players can embark on a special holiday, and you can basically complete quests and stuff inside of the browser itself and get awesome rewards for Raid as well. Thank you, Lenny, for the Mosh Pit MVP subscription. I appreciate that. Welcome to the Mosh Pits. So go over to RaidXmas.com. I'll go ahead and post that in the link or in the chat right now. For everyone to go check it out. You can go do that and sign up there, and you can play the mini games. It's really, really cool. And help Sir Nicholas, which I'll show you if I can find him. Where can I find Sir Nicholas? He's under, I don't remember what he's actually under. He's under one of the he might be hidden, actually. He might be hidden. Either way, Sir Nicholas, he's an awesome champion you can find. I think maybe I can see him in the portal. Summon pool. Yeah, there he is. Sir Nicholas. It's literally like boss Santa Claus. I would love to get Sir Nicholas. He looks awesome. He's got like a big glowing sword. I love that he's got antlers on the back and everything. He looks like something you'd see out of Game of Thrones. Looks really sick. Really, really cool. So definitely go check it out. Download Raid Shadow Legends today, everyone. We're going to do some summons as well. To get started with this stream, again, I want to thank Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this segment of the stream. It's really awesome that they wanted to run it back with a Mosh Pit. And if you want to support my channel, everyone, but you don't necessarily want to play the game, you can still click the like button, leave a comment down below that just shows the company that, you know, you all appreciate them giving their time and also effort and money and sponsoring my channel. I really appreciate that, and they would as well. It'd be really cool. So. All right. And again, you can use my tracking link right here, everybody. If you have not already signed up for the game, you go ahead and do that there. That is the link that you can go to. Don't worry. It's safe. I promise. It's a safe link. I wouldn't put it there if it wasn't safe. You can click on that. Download the game. Play it on PC. Play it on mobile. It's a lot of fun. So, all right. Here we go. I'm going to go and start these summons, and then we'll go take down some bosses. I'll show you some PvP. and answer any questions that you all might have for me. So again, there is a 2x summoning event that's happening tomorrow that I really should be saving these for, but I bought these specifically for the stream. And I'll try not to pull a PSA 8 character. I do not have I don't have any legendaries. I want to show you real quickly. I have zero legendaries or Legos. I've got zero legendary characters, okay? Every single character that you see here on the left side, all of these champions were gotten by free, okay? My account technically is no longer free to play because I bought stuff for the stream. But as you can see, I have zero legendaries, zero. So I'm hoping that we get my first tonight. That would be a really nice Christmas, post-Christmas present. I've got a couple of decent rares like Duke. Duke the Pierced, he's considered to be pretty good. He's not quite as meta anymore, according to Hell Hades, which is a great website, by the way, that you all should check out. I've got some other not great epics in there. But main goal here tonight is going to be hopefully getting a legendary. Pray. So let me see some good luck, some little sissies, some sparkles, everything in there. The main link that you want is the tracking link, McCaton. The pl.go/ga.me, that one. That's the one that you want to be using. The Raid Xmas, that one is for the Yuletide event that Raid is currently doing. And that's going to be a way to jumpstart your account as well. But you want to create your account and download the link via my tracking link first, which you can find there on the spam from Limiting Zero. And again, thank you again, Moshpit, for allowing me to do this. Whew, let's do it. Hello, Dylan Brunko. Thank you very much. The stream overlay counters, I believe that is for people who sign up via that link, I think. Or that might be how many people sign up and hit level 6. Hitting level 6 in this game is really, really easy. So, awesome, Aluka. And again, we do have a clan. We have a Mosh Pit clan, which you can, it's invite only because, again, we're trying to stay super active. But we have one spot right now. So, If someone signs up, if you get on quick and you're gonna play, sign up and unlock clans and then just apply to official Mosh Pit is the name of it. We have the tag Mosh, and sign up. All right, let's do it. No problem, Danny Cooper. I appreciate you. Let's start. You want to start with ancient shards? Let's start with ancient shards. Limiting Zero, and we'll work our way up. So ancient shards, the base is generally gonna be rare. That's the lowest possible rarity we can get. You can get all the way up to legendary, which I've never gotten before. Then we'll go to void shards. We'll do ancient shards, void shards, sacred shards, and then finally primal shards. Maybe we'll get a mythical. I doubt it with Sinvicta luck, but who knows? Here we go. I got 48 shards to start off with ancient shards. Let's go. Will I get my first ever legendary? Got a rare. Or we got epic, I mean. We got Scabrius? Scabrius? He's a rat. It's Coach Krendor. What's he do? He's got poison? Yeah. Leech, weaken. Okay, we got Scabrius. Let's do another one. Ratman. 3,000 coins tells me that we didn't get... We may have gotten another epic, maybe. Yeah, there he is. Seize. He's another Ogryn. I'm not gonna look at everything here because we still have a lot of stuff to talk about. Thank you, Sirkoyas. I appreciate that. Okay, we got a War Maiden. So what's nice about dupes in this game, I'll show you really quickly. If you get a duplicate champion, you can actually use them to level up skills. So we go to the tavern. My skills aren't upgraded. So normally you would use these what's called skill books, and that's the only way that you can upgrade your champion skills, and they also deals more damage for this one, and then this one also lowers the cooldown on her A3, which is really cool. But no pun intended there. But if you get dupe champions like we just did with War Maiden, instead of using like these very valuable rare skill books, you can actually use the champion themselves to upgrade a skill. So watch this. We sacrifice a champion, and we get Ferocious Attack level 2, which I think is her A1. Yeah, A1. So now we do 5% more damage on Ferocious Attack, which is really cool. So there's always value in anything that you do in games like this, especially in Raid for dupes and all that kind of good stuff, so it's really cool. Targeted champion boost. Check summon in for... Oh, yeah, I think we have a 10x chance to get from Ancient Shards Xena. Maybe Xena will be my... As in, like, warrior princess. Maybe Xena will be my first legendary. Yeah, it's like opening booster packs, exactly. Yeah, so we did get another epic. I got an apothecary, let's go. And gory. Yo, gory sounds metal. I have badly needed apothecary. So I'm happy about that. What is gory? Oh man. Dude, he looks metal as all heck. Attacks one enemy two times, plays an extra hit if the target is under a freeze debuff. Heals champion by 10% of the damage inflicted. So he's got natural vamp. Frost Jutsu. Frost Breaker. Counterattack. Dude, he looks cool. He looks metal, man. I like him. Don't know if I'll use him, but I have to go to Hell Hades to see how good he is. Alright, one more 10 pull here for the ancient shards. Yes, they are different, Drano. Another apothecary. No, we didn't get an epic this time. Oh, I got a Diabolus as well. She's actually a farmable champion from stage 12, but I've never gotten her. So, okay. Good. We have eight more ancient shards left. We'll rip through them real quick. So this is what happens when you get a rare. You'll just see blue. Another rare, okay. Got Odachi. You can expect mostly rares here. Rough stone. He looks like a rough stone. If I've ever seen a rough stone, that'd be him. How you doing, Dune Strider? Come on. Give me one epic. Or legendary. I'll take a legendary. We got Pounder. I barely even knew her. Coffin Smasher, dude. Now we're talking. Yeah, we got lucky on the epics, I will admit. Yeah, character design is awesome. Wretch. Got a broken head. Definitely check out the link there, everybody. If you've not already, download it through my tracking link. You can go do so. Fury Stoker. Let's take a bath. All right, so that is all of our ancient shards. I only have six capacity left there. So, I'm just going to upgrade my capacity because now we're going to move on into void shards. Now void shards have a much higher chance at not giving yourself a rare. In fact, you can see what the percentage totals here are. So we have 8% chance for, well, they're basically, you get a void. You want void champions. Let's put it that way. You want void champions, which is the purple affinity. And hopefully we get one to show you all. So if I rip a 10 on void, I mean, I don't want to waste too much time summoning. All right, let's do it. Sure. Increase my champion slots. I'll use gems. I've got plenty of gems from buying all those packs. Here we go. They're only void champions. I gotcha. Oh. Got Ostrock's Boneglaive. Okay. Cold Heart is considered to be one of the best rares, if not the best rare in the game. So I'm pretty stoked to have her. Ostrock's Boneglaive. He's part of the Undead Horde faction. He's like maybe a healer. What is that? Has a 70% chance of transferring one random debuff from this. Oh, so it transfers debuffs from him to a target. Okay. Yeah, Cold Heart is insanely good. She's considered, I think, the best rare in the game. So, I'm really stoked to have her. Ostrox looks like he gives good hugs. All right, let's rip these void shards here. We want to see purple or orange. Malbranche. How you doing? Rare. And we got an epic! Gala Long Braids, or Gala Long Braids. Part of the dwarfs. She's got some hair, man. Those clasps though. All right, we got an epic. Happy with an epic. Brown Bloat Wraith. He's learned how to swim. Oh no, legendary cage bound. Long Braids is advertised. Steadfast Marshal. Come on now. Come on. Give me a legend. Give me a void legendary. How amazing would that be? We got Marquis or Marcus. See you later, Lenny. Thank you again for the sub. This VOD will be up. This VOD will be up on YouTube. So don't worry if you miss the rest of it. You can always come back. Last void shard here. Legendary. Darn. Got Justicar. Okay. Still, we're still striking out here. I need some good juju. Now we're getting to the big boy shards. Sacred shards, they start on epic. So their base pull is an epic. So we want something massive here. We have a 16% chance. A 94% chance for a epic, a 6% chance for legendary, dude. 6%. Surely we'll get lucky, right? Right? Come on. Okay, we're starting off with Pestilus. Looks really metal. Part of the Knights Revenant faction. Yo, that's a sick design. Look at that. Look at that. Nastier says, I've always avoided this game due to all the sponsorship on every channel, and yet here I am installing it now. Well, again, I appreciate that, and Raid does as well. Of course, it's a massive game, and they've sponsored people way bigger than me, but, you know, I felt that they would enjoy their time in the mosh pit, and we've been enjoying it. The mosh pit's been playing it nonstop. I love that character design. Thank you, Mike S., for the €5 donation. I appreciate that. We have Mike's donation luck. All right, here we go. Come on. Come on. Legendary. I've never gotten a legendary this game. Please. Okay, another epic, of course. Deathless. Again, another Knights Revenant champion. At least she doesn't have to worry about her hair. Her hair is locked in tight. Grave Whispers, Grim Revenge. Decreased defense and speed and accuracy. Sacred shards are better than Sacred Orb. Yeah. Come on. Come on. Another epic. Mistress of Hymns. How you doing? How you doing? Part of the Sacred Order faction. Legendary first try. We're still waiting. We only have 5 left. Please. Come on. Stag Knight. Dude, look at the size of that shield. Oh my gosh. You talk about the side of a barn door right there. Evion blesses us with a legendary eventually. Increased defense attacks all enemies at 70% chance of placing a 60%. Oh, so that's a big boy defense decrease buff. Debuff. And 50%. Wow, yeah. Has a 70% chance for a 2-turn decreased defense and defense break and attack break. That is sick. Places a 50% increased attack buff on an ally for 1 turn. On an ally for 1 turn each time the ally has a debuff resisted by the enemy. Wow. And that's automatic. Yeah, that's just a passive. Okay. All right. I do like his armor. Oh, we got first legendary, Crypt Gang Grail. I don't care. Dude, he looks metal. Undead Hordes. Let's go. First try. Yo, our first legendary. He's a support. I don't know if he's good or not. He's got a lot of reviews. Yo. He's got an attack. He has attack break. 60% chance of taking has 100% chance of hitting if it's under HP burn or freeze. Damage based off attack. Okay. Death fires level 1 attacks all enemies, has a 75% chance of placing HP burn debuff. 75% base chance. Yo. It can be upgraded all the way. It can be upgraded all the way to 100% at level 5. Elemental Unity attacks all enemies, places freeze debuff on each target for 1 turn if they're under HP burn. Damn it. Ascendant skill attacks all enemies. Turns of the owner, so it goes up to 3 turns, and the HP burn cannot be resisted. Holy moly. And it also has a 33% HP increase for all allies that put at the leader skill. Wow, that is really good. I don't know if he's super good, but El Hades rates him as a 4, so it's pretty good. Hey, it's my first legendary. Crypt King Grail. I'll take him. We got 2 left. Surely we won't get another one, right? 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 We have Wuji. We have 1 more to go. Shadow can always look cool. They're like a samurai ninja faction. Looks really sick. We have 1 left. Come on. One more time. Oh, we got another one! Trunda Guilt Mallet. We got another one, though. Yo, 2 Legos in 8 shards. Wow. 12,000 reviews. Oh, man. She's not been skipping leg day. Golden Mallet attacks 1 enemy 2 times. Has 50% chance of placing a stun. Okay. Attacks 1 enemy. Then attacks all other enemies with a second hit. So her A2 isn't just a straight up AoE. Forge Rhythm attacks all enemies with 70% chance of stun. Whoa, wow, it's all stun. Places HP burn debuff with enemies. Okay. And her passive Swift Justice increases the resistance. Enemies increase 10 for. Oh, wow. So her resistance goes up for each stun she hits. So, wow. Look at that. Gunner. Okay, we have 9 more shards to go. These are primal shards. Now, these are the ones that you can actually get mythicals from. Suffice to say, we're probably not going to get a mythical. We're probably not going to get a legendary. Not a 1% chance for legendary, 0.5% chance for mythical. But what if? But what if? Just think, what if? Download Raid Shadow Legends, everyone, with my tracking link that you can find right there. I would appreciate it. But what if, though, right? Just imagine. You gotta believe. We got an Honor Guard. We're back to getting rares now, by the way. Becoming mythical? Dude, I don't even know what I would do. Metal Shaper. He's a crocodile with freaking glaives on his hands. Show me red. Just show me red. We got Gator. Well, that's a Gator, but the other one was a Metal Shaper. First try mythical. Kale usually Drano. Kale is usually what I would say go to. He's going to be the... Kale is the one who's going to take you the furthest, the fastest. Him. Because he has poison, he has AoE, he's very, very strong. He can take you all the way through the entire game. And you get like a free vampiric set, I think, at some point. You put on him and he basically will hard carry you through everything in the game. Everything for the campaign, anyway. 5 primals left. Come on, please. Gotta believe. Another Odachi. We got a bombardier. We got legendary and another dwarf, Mountain King. What? Why am I getting? Is my account flagged for dwarves or something? We got another dwarven legendary. He's got a sick axe though. Mythic is red. Thundercleave attacks 1 enemy based on HP. Enchanted axe attacks 1 enemy based on HP and attack. Ignore 50% of the damage of, or 50% of the target's defense. Regal Force attacks 1 enemy. It will ignore shield and block damage. Yeah, he doesn't look very good. Well, it's another legendary. I got small luck. Got Preserver. How you doing? How you doing? Last Primal Shard. Okay. Got marked. War Maiden with makeup. But hey, look at that. We got legendaries. Really, 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 really stoked about that. We got three legendaries, dude. We got Crypt King Grail. Apparently, Trunda is the best legendary I have. And then also the Mountain King, which may not be very good. But that's dope. And we got some epics as well. I'm really, really stoked that we got Coldheart. Where'd she go? Oh my god, there's so many rares now. Diabolist, I'm very happy that we got one of them. We got two Apothecaries. Yo, super stoked about that. It's going to be fun to level up. Where'd Coldheart go? I don't see her. I may have passed her somewhere. There she is, Coldheart. Bam. Super stoked about that. Super stoked. Yeah. All right, let's go and do some. Let's do some quick PvP here. Gonna refresh the list, and we got some daily quests. There's all kinds of daily quests, all kinds of content you can do every single day, where you get good rewards, you get energy, you get gems, you get silver, you get all kinds of stuff for just plowing through the game. I usually do PvP on auto because I'm kind of low rank. I'm in silver right now. So these teams are not—they're not being played by a person, but they are set up by a person. We're gonna lose. We might actually lose. There's Kale getting the poison out. His Kale got their poison out. Hello, Van Henden. That one actually died, and then that healed Barangiri. Uh oh! Ignore defense. It's 1v4, I think. Kale, you got to kill him. There we go. That's the power of Kale. And because he killed someone that healed Barangiri. Oh, you're done. You're done, son. There we go. What a comeback. Big time Kale plays. Look at that, 95K. Barangiri did zero damage. That team's probably too tough. This one has like an ascended Kale. I need more tokens. I have tokens in my inbox. This one's got like an awakened Kale. Uh-oh. It either means he's really good or they're just trying to tank the rating for easier arena teams. Oh, we got this. He didn't have any lifesteal. There we go. I have John, yes. But out of respect for the sponsors, I won't be talking about those games. Right now, we're talking about Raid Shadow Legends, the sponsor of this segment. Really, really have been enjoying this. I got to do my clan boss as well. So clan bosses, this is where you're going to be wanting to spend the majority of your time trying to get early game rewards from. They go all the way up to a knight's chest, which can give you void shards. It can give you ancient shards, gems. You have these potions here, which are used to ascend your characters, which I'll show you in a moment. Skill books, all kinds of gear, all the way up to legendary gear, which is really cool. The whole shebang. I'm gonna try to do hard mode here just to show you, because I only have one key. My clan boss team is not fully optimized yet. I haven't gotten Taragi the Frog in yet, so this is going to be probably not great. I can usually get about 2.5 to 3 million damage on hard mode clan boss. And I emphasize you can manual all this stuff if you wanted to. I've seen Hell Hades do like a 3.5 hour like clan boss run, and he's gotten like millions of damage. I think the world record for clan boss is like 2.1 billion damage, which I don't even want to know how long that took. But the entire clan bands together and tries to take down these big bosses. And again, you get really good rewards from doing these. Now I'll show you the Cursed City update, which is the newest update that came in this past month. which I have not gotten into yet because it's super end game. Although you can go in there earlier, I guess. If you, I think it's level 42 was whenever you unlock it. I just unlocked it. But it's super tough. Like, really, really, really tough. So see here, this is all auto right now. I think I'm about to lose Luria. He's going down. Kale usually stays alive the longest because he's got Life Leech. It's 52 unlock. Okay, there you go. No, I can't. Is it 52? Because I'm pretty sure that I unlocked it already. And yeah, check out that tracking link that Limiting Zero just posted in the chat, everybody, or down below in the description. Okay, it's 52. Use my tracking link and sign up for Raid Shadow Legends. Again, this is a sponsored segment of the stream. You get some awesome rewards for hitting level 12, which I'll go ahead and show you after the clan boss. It's going to be Kale. Now it's just one-on-one. Kale versus this giant devil of a clan boss. He's actually Demon Lord, but... All right, so we end up doing 2.5 million. That's actually pretty low for me, which kind of sucks, but that's all right. So your damage, the damage that you do gives you... it. The rewards that you get is based off the damage that you do. So the higher damage that you do, the better the rewards, which is really... He's like, think of him like a big punching bag. But again, if you sign up right now, everybody, with that tracking link... you get yourself a starter pack there, which includes an epic Drake character that you can start your account right away. And also, if you happen to hit level 12, you get some really awesome rewards here from hitting level 12 in your account. You get energy refill. You also get an XP booster. You get a brand new champion, or not brand new champion, but a very awesome solid champion, Rector Drath. I actually don't have her because she was put in the game long after I actually started playing the game. You also get 200,000 silver and one epic skill tome, which you can use to ascend your characters, your champion skills in the tavern, which again, I will show you in just a moment. So definitely check it out. Those are the rewards for hitting level 12 on your account. If you use my sign up link, you can also get the starter pack immediately right away by getting the epic Drake character, which you can see right there, and all those loots, all the goodies. And again, thank you to Raid for sponsoring this stream. Let's hop back into it and I'll show you what the Cursed City is. This is something that I have not done yet. I guess I could start. I could start with it just to show you. Although I don't have, do I have any keys? I do have keys. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Let's put. I'm gonna put. No. Give me Kale. Give me some HP. Only 15% HP, but let's see. I'll show you the gem mine in a second, Drano. Give me 2 seconds. So you're actually, it looks like that we're actually limited in what and who we can bring here. These are the conditions right here. So we can only bring dark elves. I think that's Sacred Order, dwarves. Not sure who that is. And the Sylvan faction. So I'm going to have to put together a ragtag group of misfits that don't have gear. That's fine. Yes, if you just started playing, you can join the clan. You just have to be active. I'm actively purging people from the clan, so make sure you stay active. This is the first time actually seeing the Cursed City, so we're starting on the outskirts. There's Alacrity. This is the first time I ever using Golden Reaper, so I've never actually seen her do anything. She's supposed to be pretty good. So we're trying to fight our way into the Cursed City. And you can definitely check it out. It's a month-long excursion into the accursed city of Centranos, currently under rule of Amius the Lunar Archon. The final boss of this mode, which I probably won't see for quite a while, to be honest. Players will need to clear stages of different types across 4 different districts. Look how big this freaking map is. Look at this. And there he is. There's the ruler of this entire city, Amius. Which, again, I'm not going to be able to see him anytime soon. But this takes an entire month entire month to go through. You have different factions. You have different districts that you can fight through. And you can take multiple branching paths, which is really cool. But first, you need to go into the stages. Or you need to go into the four districts to hunt down the three Eclipse Keys. And then once you have those keys, then you may enter into the center of the Cursed City and fight Amius, the Lunar Archon. So you have to search for the Eclipse Keys from these various districts here. Let me zoom out. But yeah, look at the size of this map. Like, this is like endgame content that we're talking about. This literally was just added in December, which is really cool. And I really think that, you know, I'm looking forward to doing this. When will I get here? I have no idea. You saw my account before we started this stream. I had zero legendary, so it's a goal. It's a lofty goal. Here you have all kinds of weekly quests. You have daily quests, which I've already done, as you can see. Again, I wasn't lying about playing this game nonstop. You can ask Limbing Zero. I've been putting hours into it. And again, if you want to join the clan, the official Mosh Pit clan, you can just simply search for it in game. And there's all kinds of festive stuff going on for the month of December as well. The Yuletide stuff, which will be ending, I think, in a couple of days. The winter events, which is really cool. You have the Hero's Path, which ends in 9 hours. You get all kinds of loot. I have so many snow coins from summoning. Oh my gosh, I might be able to unlock like everything. That'd be cool. Yeah, I'll take the Soul Essence. Give me the Skill Tomes. Give me Bobos. So you can use those for fusions, which I'll show you in just a moment. Okay, I mean, I'll take some energy. We got a 6-star Epic Chaos Core, which is used for accessories and artifacts. 500 energy. Yeah, we can go all the way down here. Get some legendary skill tomes, which is good. Have ourselves an event key that unlocks this here. If I wanted to get the Split Soul of Blizzard, the Howler Spirit Soul. Split Soul, I mean. Split Soul? Yeah, Split Soul. Give me the legendary tome first, and I can get this avatar. That looks pretty metal. Mythical skill tome. Now, am I ever going to get a mythical champion? Probably not, but I should probably get these skill tomes while I can, because those are going to be the hardest thing to get in all of the game. And there's really cool like beginner tournaments and stuff that you can do as a fresh account. You'll have access to tournaments that I won't have, like, you know, clear campaign bosses in so many turns. You get points and you get rewards based on how many clan bosses you do, campaign bosses you do. You have all the rewards on the right hand side. This ranks you against a pool of all these other people. So like this one right here, clear Dragon's Lair in as few turns as possible to win incredible rewards. So this is what you get for placing in the ladder. I'm 59 because I haven't done Dragon yet. And then these are guaranteed rewards as long as you get to these tournament points standings, which in this one, you just go fight dragon, you get points. Very simple. So, and again, here's our clan. Who is it? There's Drano. We got Drano. All right. Drano, you're in. Level 4. Bam. And again, I'm gonna be removing people. People who are not active get removed pretty much immediately. So we want to try to keep people active. If you're not in the clan already, don't worry about it. I'm always purging people. Make sure you know how to check in. If you ever want to learn how to get stars and earn clan XP, just hit this I button up here. This will tell you exactly what you can do for clan activity quests. All these stuff is very important for when you join a clan to stay active, that sort of thing. So welcome, Drain. Welcome, welcome. I want to see... Whoops. Where is... There's Trunda. Trunda looks fierce. I do have upgrade tomes. I don't know if I should use them on her, but always check in at least. Yeah, but I want to see more. So this is Ascension here. So Ascension, you get... I'm going to go ahead and send her once. So that's what turns these stars up here purple, and it just increases their stats. But if you go up to a certain level, it also starts to give you other benefits as well. So like if we get her to 2-star Ascension, which I'm going to do right now, she just gets more basic base stats here. But then 3-star Ascension, look at this. One of her skills becomes something else. It's the Cloak of Ages. It turns into something else. Let me go look at her description here. Yeah, so upon ascending to 3 stars, attacks one enemy, then attacks all other enemies with a second hit, dealing 60% of the damage inflicted from the first hit. So I really, really, really want to get to 3-star Ascension for Trunda. The problem is that I don't have enough resources to do that. I need more of these I need more of these. The greater mat. I think these are greater or major. So unfortunately, the magic keep is not open right now. I might be able to up convert. Let's see. Yeah. So that's only going to make six. I don't do much farming for the potions. Mainly because I'm always farming for trash. As in like food. Like I'm always farming food. I have a fragment summon? Oh yeah. That's right. We got 25 fragments for Bovos. He's part of a fusion, which you can do, by the way. You can there's fusion champions that you can make. So like if we really, really wanted to get Blizzard, we could. We just need 4 5-star fully ascended Bovoses. So it takes a while. Like I said, you have to use your time wisely in raid. But you also, at the same time, I don't want that to put people off. You don't have to take it too seriously. It's all fun and games at the end. You can play exactly how you want and just play it how you want. I've been taking it more seriously, especially now that I'm not free to play. I'm definitely going to be sinking some money into the game to get some more summons. I really want a mythical. If you haven't seen what a mythical champion looks like, let's show you one mythical. These are all legendary. Who has a mythical? Sacred Order? Yeah. Sigfrid the Nephilim. That's a mythical champion right there. I don't know how many people have him. I will have a mythical. If raid runs it back, mark my words, I will have a mythical champion. He looks sick. I don't even know what he does. He just looks sick. I would love to have a mythical. Look at that sword, man. That just looks so cool. Like the art design in this game is phenomenal. It really is phenomenal. It's so good. I'll show you what dragon is really quickly for those of you who want to see how you get gear for your champions. Yeah, they have two forms as well. So dragon, so these are the dungeons. This is where you get potions from to ascend your champions. Minotaur's Labyrinth, this is where you're going to be getting these scrolls, which you can use to unlock the masteries. And then these, Spider's Den, Ice Golem's Peak, Dragon's Lair, Fire Knight, and Sand Devil, all of these, and Phantom the Shogun as well, all of these, which you won't have access to these for a while, but all of these are used to basically get a to get all your gear from. Now it looks like there's a rush going on right now. I guess that means that we're getting more speed drops, something, I don't know. Let's find out. Hello, Keon JG. So fighting dragon, this is the first dragon that you see when you first do the tutorial in the game. And this is where you're going to be spending a majority of your time getting the best gear that you can for, like, you know, your chest pieces, your weapons, your boots, your gloves, all that kind of stuff. All that comes from a dragon and also the campaign. You can also get them from the campaign, which is where you're going to be getting most of your gear from to start with. Again, I'm still kind of in the early game. no, the speed does not go past times 2. And again, one final time, everyone, go check out that tracker link that you see there from Limiting Zero. If you use that, that tells Raid that you downloaded it from my stream, which is very cool. And it supports myself as well as, again, just shows Raid that the Mosh Pit is worth sponsoring. And I'm so happy that we actually got to do another one here for Raid. And, you know, thank you, everyone, who's used the link to sign up so far. Really cool. And before we end the sponsored segment of tonight, I want to show you that it's not all serious when it comes to to Raid. They've got some really funny commentary and really funny videos, which I'll show you after this dragon ends up. I think we might lose. I can't. My dragon team isn't optimized at all. Again, you know, I'm totally free to play. Well, I was. But I'm definitely going to be farming hard for gear now that I'm getting better champions. But you can go through the entire game totally free to play and clear all the content. It just takes a lot longer to do, obviously. But there are some fantastic free champions that you get. Oh no, we're going to beat them. We got this. Yeah, there we go. And we didn't get a gear. Of course we didn't. We got a Void Brew, which, yeah, Void Brews you can use in the tavern. They're basically like giant XP boosts. So let me show you Cold Heart real quick. Yeah. So if I wanted to upgrade, if I didn't want to like spam like campaign levels over and over again, I can simply just use the Void Brew. You want to match their affinity. So you see this purple triangle right here. This is their affinity. You simply just match that and look how many levels she gets. 10 levels for one brew. Heck yeah. There we go. Yeah, I need to build Void or Cold Heart. She looks so cool. So really quickly, I want to show you a very fun video here produced by Raid Shadow Legends to close it out, just to show you that, you know, again, I really enjoy the game. I think that you can take it as serious as you want to, or as casual as you want to, but they do have a really fun one that I enjoyed watching last time. We're going to watch it again. And again, thank you to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this segment of the stream. Check this one out. It's pretty good. The production quality is so great. I love it.
Really? That's pathetic.
I was super stoked when I got Zargala in Raid Shadow Legends. She's a badass warrior princess and has helped me slay many bosses. But in real life, well...
Bigger. No, bigger!
Ah! What? You know I'm vegan, right?
Oh, well, that explains a lot.
Then again, she has her moments. Oh, man. This is gonna take forever.
I got this.
Get the most out of your champions in Raid Shadow Legends. Download for free.
Download it for free via my tracker link. Thank you again, Raid Shadow Legends, for sponsoring the stream. It was very awesome. And shout out to my agency as well, SideQuest Media, for allowing this and facilitating this. It was really a lot of fun. And again, I'm going to continue to play Raid and just keep going with the account progression. And getting those legendaries today was really good. And yeah, thank you, Mosh Pit, for watching. We'll be back to Isaac in just a moment. How do you join the clan? You have to apply to it. Apply to it, McCaden, but we're currently full because I've been booting people who are basically inactive. And 30 members is the max that we have right now. I think that's the max total, but I'm always purging people. So people who are slacking, they get yeeted very quickly. So thank you, Raid, and thank you to Lemming Zero as well for posting those copy paste for me as well, since the bot wasn't working. And yeah, it's really cool. Really, really cool. Thank you, everybody. Go check it out. I hope that everyone enjoys it. Low B short. Mama Zero. Yeah, thanks, everybody, for allowing me to do that. I appreciate it. It's a good game. Like it's solid. I know that Raid is a meme, but you know, it's also an absolutely massive game. Absolutely massive game that's a lot of fun. And you know, I'm a sucker. I love playing mobile games. I love playing Hero Collectors and stuff.
Isaac and his mother.
And you know, I have a lot of experience in them because I played other ones, which we're still technically sponsored right now, so I can't mention them, but I played other Hero Collector games, mobile games. Those of you who watch me on Twitch, you know the games that I'm talking about. I played them before. And I didn't really think too much of Raid when I first saw it, but you know, after playing it, now that I know the systems, it's just as good, if not better, than most of them out there. I played Idle Heroes, yes. Wasn't a huge fan of it. What? Yeah, we're still waiting for Sacred Orb to do something. Oh yeah, I gotta report to the network. Hang on 1 second. I don't really play console anymore. I have a PS4 and I have a PS5 that I haven't even opened. Ever since going to PC, I've not gone back. Apparently for us to go north, we have to go west. I have plenty of PSA-8s. I was going way too ham with the pay to win. Yeah, I never got that far in that game. And truth be told, like, I was planning on staying free to play in Raid. but since I did the free, like, I didn't have a whole lot of shards. Because I just, like, as soon as I get them, like, I instantly rip them. But did we lose our double deal again? Whatever. But I thought I wanted to do something fun for this stream, especially since it's like the second stream, you know, show everyone like what you can get if you do decide to spend a little bit of money in the game. I really did want a legendary champion. I'm glad I got a couple of them. I'm glad I got one, let alone three, even though two of them might be not so worth it. Thank you, Roy Robinson, for the $20 super chat. Happy New Year, Sin. Thanks for another great year of daily content. Thank you, Roy, for continuing to be here as well. Didn't we take shielded tears? We did, and they're not doing anything. We got the angel deal with an 18%. Oh! Big Pog plays. And we're right back to it. Now we have to confirm if Sacred Orb gave us Sacred Heart. Yeah. Yeah, we'll run this run back with the same seed just to see. 6 o'clock. We'll run it back with the same seed to see what Sacred Orb did and didn't do. I still maintain that Sacred Orb is mid. I'm not convinced. And your first year being subscribed, I believe. Thank you for all the content. I'm currently at university. When I can afford to be, I'll be joining your Patreon. Hey, thank you very much. Thank you, Jason. Congrats on completing year one. It only gets easier. First year at college is always it's a very eye-opening experience. And then after you get done with the first year, you realize, oh, it's just high school, but I get to live my life on my own now. I'm now super responsible for everything that I do. College is the best time of your life, I promise you. Wafer. Oh! Oh. Oh my god. Yeah, we're not sponsored anymore. We already did the raid segment. Hello, Lamine. Bonjour. 3 years in, one to go. Oh, okay. Yep. Down. like how the tears down horse pill didn't even affect us. So mad about it, though. Sacred Orb making plays? You can't say that. It's not guaranteed that Sacred Orb's making the plays. We're going to run the seed back in a second. Although I do need to go get a drink because my voice is starting to go. We're going to run the seed back in a second, and then we'll truly see who is responsible for what. Oh, I forgot to put the seed. What was the seed? Does anyone remember? I looked at it at the very beginning of the stream. Well, it's a good time for me to take a break. You can rewind the VOD and go check out the seed and type it in chat. Yeah, there it is. Jeb's mitdb. Thank you, Garrick. But I'll be right back, everyone. I just need to take a quick break and rest my voice and go grab a drink. Highly suggest you all do the same, and I'll be back in a moment. Thank you for hanging out, and thanks for sticking around after the raid portion of the stream. I really appreciate it. I'll be on raid tonight. But I'll be back in a moment. Thank you, everyone. See you in a few. Hey, everybody. Yes, this is Thrive. This is Thrive, our first track off of The album. Check it out. It's metal. All right. Bonus run. We're going to see what Sacred Orb did or didn't do on that seed. Excuse me. That version is the very, very old version on Spotify. That's like the super old version. What am I missing? Was that not the right seed? Thank you, Aluka. Why is it not working? JEBSMTTTB. What? No, don't put anything in the Drake drain. See you later, Alex Hoffman. Thank you. Why was it not working the first time? Am I going insane? Anyway, okay. Now, I'm not going to take Death Certificate this time. Or I'm not going to take Sacred Orb this time. I'm going to take Rock Bottom this time. We'll see... We'll see which one was better. Sorry. I was doing D? Oh, well, that's my bad then. No. Playing a seeded run doesn't affect your win streak. Yeah, I wouldn't care too much about those stats, Kringle. Those stats are always inaccurate. The heck is Rock Bottom? Thank you, Andrew, for the $10 super chat. Lost the bet. What was the bet? Hang on. What was the bet, Andrew? I don't see it in chat. I'm not going to take chaos because that's going to screw up. We're trying to see if Sacred Orb had any effect on that run. Or whether or not I got Rock Bottom. I'm going to take Rock Bottom. Oh, the bet was I wouldn't take Rock Bottom. No, I'm going to take Rock Bottom. Usually in that room. I feel like I'm going insane. I'm honestly, I'm about to just give it to myself with the console. I missed it? Where did I miss it? Oh, there it is. Okay. So let's see if Sacred Orb actually had any effect on the items that we get. Smart Fly. That was the same exact, pretty sure that was the same exact first item. It was a fly item. Actually, it was a it's a death certificate start. Oh, Margum. Godhead is way more rare than Redemption. That's true, yeah. 4-1 will be the same. That's true. I'm hungry too. All right, so now Sacred Orb was in effect for this run. A sub sounds good. I want chicken, I think. I want some Mama Victa's chicken and noodles. Maybe I'll make that tonight. Early death certificate item is the stairway to get angel deals. Your late one is Sacred Heart. I mean, I don't hate that. I don't hate that strategy at all. No, I don't want fried chicken. I want some Mama Victa's chicken and noodles. That sounds good. No, not. Don't ever equate chicken Alfredo with Mama Victa's chicken and noodles. It's blasphemous right there. Oh, Lissa. Honestly, I could go for a chicken parm. Chicken parm sounds good. Okay, so we have bird cage. Oh, Havoc Pineapple. Magic 8 Ball instead of D20. Yeah, so Bag of Crafting was the doing of Sacred Orb, which I'm going to be honest, I'd rather have Birdcage than Bag of Crafting. I'm just saying. H Pizzle. Bag of Crafting is meh. You know what else is meh? Sacred Orb. Aww. champion belt. I'm gonna use the chariot just so we get the movement speed. Care about the little card. Yeah, thank you again, everybody. Seriously, for letting me do the sponsored stuff with Raid. I was really surprised and super stoked that they wanted to run it back, because they really did enjoy the way that I presented it the first time, and they're like, hey, you just want to run it back? And I was like, yeah, I'm down to clown. I mean, I wouldn't be able to do it without y'all, so thank you very much. Get him, Birdcage, get him. Hey, Magic's Cab. I want champion belt real bad. Yeah, I'm gonna play this as how I would have played it. Because people were like, oh, you gotta go Angel Deals if you take Sacred Orb. And I was like, okay. Well, no, I guess I take that back. I should have gone Angel Deals if we want true 1-to-1. There's the compass. I'm not gonna be able to get the compass. Unless. Are there any more hearts? I don't think there's any hearts. Yeah, I just thought about that. I mean, I can give myself Eucharist. I'm gonna give myself Eucharist. Do we remember what floor? Because I can remove Eucharist on the floors. Do we remember what floors we got Angel Deals on? I can give myself Eucharist so we're guaranteed Angel Deals. Well, no, the whole point of me doing the second run was to see what level of impact Sacred Orb had. I'm saving strength. The womb 2, Angel Deal gave us Sacred Heart, okay. Back altar. Womp womp. Yeah, that was Guppy's head. So we already got Guppy's head on 4-1. Everyone, please click the like button. Only 300 some odd likes right now. I'd love to get to 1K on that. I would appreciate it. The analytics do matter for the sponsored stuff. Come on. Lemon mishap, hooray. Thank you, everyone. Up to 400 likes already. Thank you. Burn Penny, it was actually kind of pog. Okay, so this stayed the same, and this got replaced by Keeper Sack. Burn Penny's kind of pog with IV Bag. I would love to see 1,000 likes on this live stream, everyone. That'd be great. My double tended rock. That one of them double tended rocks right there. Hold the butter. Yo, Hungry Soul doing some work. That's where the Super Seeker Room is. Come on. All I wanted was just one bomb, Burnt Penny, after I just got done, like, talking you up. All right, we got to get Pentagram here, right? Right? Did we get an Angel Deal on floor 3? Bro. Hello, Patrick. We did not get one on floor 3. Floor 4, okay. So on floor 4, I'll give myself a Eucharist. I got Stairway from Sack Room on this floor. Okay. Yeah, everyone keeps saying that the orb gave us Keeper Sack, but I think you might be forgetting that we didn't get a whole lot out of Keeper Sack. Because we had a greed fight. We didn't have a lot of money to buy stuff with. For Dolly. I want Pentagram, dang it. Yeah, that was the same. I guess we did well, we didn't, like, how much did we buy from the stairway, though? I don't think there's a way to get rid of the heart. I think you have to block the element with a particular type of ad blocker. Breath of life. Breath of Life. Mm-hmm. So we would not have gotten Stairway. Bro. No, I'm not multi-streaming. That's Birdcage. Did we... I mean, the pentagram's still worth it, but... Multi-streaming is allowed, but I don't do it anyway, because it's two different communities that I interact with there.
Wow.
Wow. I think this is going to get our sun card, though. Yep. Good. Great. So we're going to miss out on our soul hearts. But so far, demonstrably, this run is not that much... It's not that much worse than what we had with Sacred Orb. If anything, it's better. Okay, so this is the floor that we got an Angel Deal on. So I have to give myself Eucharist before we go to the boss. Our damage is great. And we don't have the range down that we did with number one. Eraser's real good with Bethany. Greed fight. Team Seru. Stars card. We didn't have that. What is a 60% keyboard? No, oh, no number pad. Okay. What? I mean, I'll take Jupiter. We take Jupiter, boys. Hey, everybody. Okay, so that wasn't orbed. But we take Jupiter all day, every day. Jupiter is top tier. Jupiter, I thought, was a really terrible item until I realized that there's no cooldown and no diminishing return on the poison. Jupiter becomes a hard carry item real quick. If you learn how to aim it, oh man. Okay, we got an Anse's Rune. That also wasn't there. Favorite planetarium item? I don't know. I really like Jupiter. Probably Uranus, but not by much. Terra is also really good. I do love Mercurius. In fact, I'd rather have probably Mercurius over Uranus. Oh, I forgot to give myself Eucharist. Well, we got an angel deal anyway. Whoops. Okay, well, we got it anyway. Immaculate Heart, exactly the same. So, I'm just saying. Hello, Ivy Bug. All I'm saying is that this is just giving more credence to the idea that Sacred Orb is mid. Hello to the Polish mosh pit. What? Oh, it freaking Conehead, stop! Conehead just screwed us twice there trying to get into that curse room. Luckfoot's different. I don't remember what this was, but we didn't get Luckfoot. Hello to the Austrian mosh pit, too. And thank you, everyone, for tuning in again. I'd love to see it. If you click the like button, we'd love to get to 1,000 likes on this live stream. It was Sharp Straw. Okay. Tech 1 was the same. And I mean, I'm taking Tech 1 all day, every day, bro. We take Tech 1 in this house. Every day, bro. Dude, stop! Conehead, I swear to God. It's trolled us 3 times in a row now where I'm trying to use IV bag to damage myself and prevent losing a soul heart. And instead, it nullifies the damage from IV bag and we take the damage on the soul heart anyway. We're replaying a run, yes. Those cricket leg, we can take that now. We might as well buy, 5 bombs for 7 cents is pretty good. Yeah, who knew that Conehead would have an anti-synergy with IV bag? More like Ivy Bug Bag. Get it? Because her name's Ivy, so IV. Now we get all the money. Did we get an angel deal on this floor, Living Zero? I guess it doesn't really matter at this point. Yeah. No! The XL4 burned both of the deals. Okay. I also think we took red heart damage, so that's probably why. Why would you daisy face me? I've done nothing that deserves a daisy face. I have done things that deserve a like, though. Sees people unlike the stream. That's a moolah. The real joke here is Sacred Orb. The real test will be to see whether or not we get Sacred Heart on Womb 2. Hello, Australia. Bonza. Good day. Pageant boy. That's just super duper great. Super awesome. It's really great. Love it. Super, super great. I miss Sharp Straw. Oh, I didn't forget the coins. Hey, look, we got 1/7 of a boss item. Okay, so we did lose everything there. Yeah, you gotta remember, I'm petty. I'm super petty when it comes to Isaac. I will purposely not take things that the game gives me. Just out of sheer principle of the matter. With diamonds. Hey, look. It's Pageant Boy times like a million. It's all about sending a message. You can't let the game... What the heck? You can't let the game get away with just giving you anything. You gotta make it own up to it. Prank card, party time. Excellent. I'm getting real tired of getting blown up by these troll bombs. Actually, you know what? I'm real tired of these war flies. Get out of here. I didn't even realize I picked up Cricket's leg and held on to it. That's what's hitting me. See, Marge? I told you I could deep fry my shirt. See? I didn't say you couldn't. I said you shouldn't. Almost at 500 likes, everyone. Thank you very much.
Ha ha ha!
600 likes, and Roy will gift 5 Mosh Pit MVP memberships to 5 lucky people. There you go. 130 left. Thank you, Roy. Got a reverse Hero Font card. I don't watch WWF or WWE, so I did not. Got another angel deal. Okay. Trinity Shield. Super duper. I probably should have used the Soul of Blue Baby, actually, because we could have gotten the creep. Nah, I don't care. Shield of Tears had no impact on that run. We did not have one on that floor. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to give myself Eucharist now. Just to guarantee that we can get into... just to guarantee that we can get into the Angel Deal. Not remove it. Not that it matters at this point, but... Sun card. Party time. Excellent. Sun card. Can use it. Boing. People have seen Wayne's World. Yeah, right now we're replaying the level. We're replaying the run that I did at the start of the stream. Which, if you missed that, everyone, or if you missed the raid portion of the stream, you can always go back and watch, rewatch the VOD. I don't know if taking Glitch Crown is going to affect the Angel Deal, so I'm not going to take it. I'll go back and take it after this Angel Deal. I'll go back and take Glitch Crown, but I'm going to wait till after we get into the Devil Deal at least. So we're replaying a seed because I was trying to explain to people that this run started off with Death Certificate, and I was going to take Rock Bottom, but then a lot of people kept insisting on Sacred Orb, so I decided to take Sacred Orb even though I normally wouldn't, because in my opinion Sacred Orb is very mid at best, and I do not think that it warrants taking in Death Certificate rooms. So we did that run, and then we did the raid Shadow Legend stream or segment, and now we're replaying the seed without Sacred Orb to show how mid it is. So let's see if Sacred Heart is in here, and it is. So Sacred Orb had absolutely nothing to do with Sacred Heart, which again leads credence to the idea that it is mid at best. I'm just saying. And yeah, I don't care about Glitch Crown. I don't care about Glitch Crown. It's not going to impact this run. I didn't forget it. I literally am not going to take it. Because we need to see if we also get... The final nail in the coffin, in my opinion, will be if we get Cricket's Head from the chest. Yeah, Glitch Crown is absolutely viable to take in Death Certificate. Did I lie to you? Because I said I was going to take Glitch Crown briefly and then decided not to? No. I don't care about Glitch Crown in this run. We didn't have Glitch Crown in the first run anyway, so it's a non-factor for what we're trying to prove here. We're trying to see whether or not we ended up getting Cricket's head from the chest. You can pause the game all you want. I tell people all the time, play this game however you want. If you wanna pause for Glitch Crown so you get the items that you want, go for it. If you wanna use the console command to give yourself items, hey, by all means. I get it. I understand. It is a single player, non-competitive roguelite. Play the game how you want. I'm not gonna besmirch you for doing any of that. Yeah, all games are made to be fun. If that's how you have fun in your game, then no one has the right to tell you otherwise. Okay, so Sacred Orb did actually get Cricket's head. But at the same time, I would have taken Rock Bottom, and we don't need Cricket's head for this run. And Deadeye. It did also give us Deadeye. But that's not till the very end of this run. Hello, Joxy. Yeah, that's not all that impressive. Point being, Sacred Orb as like a go-to pick in a floor one death certificate doesn't really give you any significant benefit in this very limited one run situation. I know that we're dealing with it's only the sample size of one run. But at the same time, we did this run basically one to one. And what I would have picked on the original run would have been Rock Bottom. And this is the run that we got. And we would have also had Glitch Crown too, obviously. And we also got Jupiter. Yeah, we made Sacred Orb appear because of Death Certificate. No, I'm not impressed by Sacred Orb all because we got Deadeye and Cricket's head in the chest at the end of a run. That doesn't impress me at all. Because at the beginning of a run, sign me up. But at the end of a run, dude, my build's already usually done by then. We get to 500 likes, everyone. I'll do a quick greed run. You have until the credits roll. We're at 498. If we get to 500 likes, I'll do a greed run real quick. 520 likes. All right. Now 80 more likes, And five people will get to join the Discord. Thank you, everybody. Yeah, so the biggest thing that Sacred Orb gave us was Keeper Sack, Cricket's Head, and Deadeye. That was it. And those are three very good items, S-tier items all the way. But by the time that we got to Cricket's Head and Deadeye, they wouldn't have mattered at the end of the run. Stairway, yeah. You join the Discord, you have to have an active either YouTube membership or a Twitch sub or be a member of the Patreon. And then link your respective accounts to Discord, and then you'll gain automatic access to our server. Yeah, again, it's Sharp Straw as well, but it's one run. It's just a sample size of one run, so. What do we want? I haven't played Samson. Let's play Samson. I haven't played Samson in a long time. Hilo Hotel Yankee Delta, Quebec Alpha Papa 6. Thank you, Addison, for the $20 Australian super chat. Super chat, because I'm loving your greed runs. I put a heart on that. Thank you very much, Addison. Very much. Happy holidays. Happy New Year. Hello, Gabor. Look, all I'm saying is, like, you can like Sacred Orb all you want. Like it all you want. I'm not saying it's a bad item. And I maintain that it's not a bad item. It's just a mid item. It's not like taking a floor one. The whole point of all this was that I wanted to show that it's not a floor one automatic take from death certificate type level of item. That's all. Thank you, Jason, for the 5 gifted subs to BD Mom. Oh boy. BD Mom's back in the Discord. Oh Lord. Goldman, Cordero, Seed, Dimples, and NK. Thank you very much, Jason. That's just what we needed. We needed BD Mom back in the Discord. Terrific. Thank you very much, Jason. We're at 575, everyone. Thank you so much. Love to get back to 1,000. If we get 1,000 likes, if we get 1,000 likes on this stream, I'll stream Isaac until 8:30 for another 90 minutes. What did BD Mom do? She's a dangerous goth girl. What didn't she do? Lo Doggo. We get to 1,000 likes on this live stream, I'll go to 8:30, which is another 90 minutes, hour and a half. I was planning on stopping after that last run. But since the Mosh Pit got us to 500 likes, figured I'd do a greed run. I might even open up a Pokemon card or two. $600 likes, Roy Robinson will be donating a We'll be gifting 5 more YouTube memberships. So people can join the Discord. You can see how much of a terror that BD Mom is. Goth girls be ruining my life. Beware the goth girl. I want my IV bag, dang it. I don't think IV bag exists in Greed, though. Hello, Robin. Bonjour. Bonjour. What? know what? I'm gonna do that. Give me my Samson damage. If you have a Twitch sub, you're automatically joined if you have your Discord accounts linked with your Twitch account, Alyssa. Ooh, girl. Damage versus tears. Man, this is tough. It's a half price tiers, and we can also get a soul heart. Oh, okay. Well, that was the right choice. Big time plays. Three likes. The 600, everyone. Thank you very much. We get the 600, and Roy gives out 5 tier 1 YouTube membership subs. And I, Adele, thank you for tuning in. I'm going to use the mystery gift inside the secret room. It's probably to the left of the shop. No, would it be between fires? It would. Say, huh? Oh! We got the 600. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Roy, for gifting out 5 gifted subs to the Mosh Pit. Striker Cloud, Carlos, Adele, Loudpack Gaming, and Robin all got a sub. You all gain access to the Mosh Pit Discord. Watching me on 8 years ongoing. Considine, thank you very much. Hook us in ain't bad in greed mode. Don't you do it. Don't you touch me. Thank you, Roy, very much. 1,000 likes, everyone, and I go till 8:30. Big time Mega Isaac plays. Thank you, Roy, very much. Very generous of you. A late Christmas present to the Mosh Pit. On our way to 700 likes, everyone. Thank you very much. If you're enjoying the stream, or if you just want to support the channel, click on the like button. All that engagement stuff is still as valuable as ever, as it ever has been on YouTube. Oh, Mega Mush doesn't do much to Mega Satan. Dango, I need you to calm down. Need both y'all to calm down. Now, there's going to be people who watch this and they're going to they're going to clip parts of the stream and say, oh, Sinvicta said the Sacred Orb is bad. No. Never once did I say Sacred Orb is bad. Sacred Orb is not a bad item. My whole point to all of that was just showing and proving that I am of the opinion that it's not an automatic floor one death certificate take. That's all I'm saying. In no way, shape, or form do I believe that Sacred Orb is a bad item. I do kind of want Squeezy. Oh! God. Do we wait on the Two of Diamonds? I mean, we have blank card Two of Diamonds. That has to be the play, right? Hello, David Viega. It's a 12 room cooldown, but still. Yeah, we just need all we need is a full charge now on the floor. Been watching football this year? Not really. I mean, I've watched a few Bucks games. And I mean, and Baker's been doing well. The problem is that Baker's doing so well that they may have probably saved Todd Bowles' job for one more season, which just guarantees that I won't watch next season either. Because I just think that it's not a fun football scheme. Baker's playing well, and I wish him the best after this season. But I really want to see just a total reset for the Bucks. Like, we're going to win the division most likely just because the NFC South is absolute trash. But yeah. I think you missed a. Yeah, so we use it now. I got to try in here. Get a nickel. Hello, Bora. Half price starter deck, too, is real nice because it allows us to carry two cards. Thank you, Seth White. I appreciate that. Yeah, rolling for a full charge is what we really need to do. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Now we have ourselves a break. Mm-hmm. 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 Hole up, let him cook. Movement speed. Here's right. Movement speed. Lump of coal. Come on, now, if this doesn't get you to like the stream, I don't know what will. Oh! Big time plays. There's so much HP. So much HP. Doink. Doink. Come on. Come on. Spun? Oh, we already got spun. Yeah, we'll take a fat out of mushroom. We're a fun guy. Mr. Dari. I'll take a blood clot. Oh, baby. Thank you, Dominic. Joker card. Oh, mercy. Chaos card. Oh, mama. Any mush? Feels like I have Sacred Orb, not gonna lie, yeah. Uncle Holy Water. Didn't even want Hamalacria, I don't really care. Sure. Why not? Rubber cement? Oh my god. Yeah, if we... All we gotta do is just beat the Saints. My most hated team. Win and we're in. Yeah, we're getting to the point where I can't see what's there. Give me a reroll. There's a... Yep. Okay. Good. Yep. All right. All right. Good. Yep. Yep. All right. Okay. All right. Here we go. I can pick up some of this money here. Yeah, well, I mean, we got plenty of money here. I'm trying to get something different. Probably should take a Nun's Habit. I mean. Okay. Okay, man. All right. Good. Go ahead and just pick that up there. There we go. All right. Good. All right. Yeah. Just take this out real quick here. Excuse me. Come on. If we get to 1,000 likes, everyone, I'll play till 8:30. But then I got to go get something to eat. Otherwise, I'm going to go crazy. Hey, we can see our HP. And I'm still not taking scatter bombs. We're only 360 out. Oh, God. Okay, hang on a second. Hang on a bloody minute. Let's go ahead and do this here real quick. All right. Dang old deep pockets, man. Dang old two diamonds, man. All right. So let's go ahead and take that here. All right, good. Let's just do this here. All right. Yeah. And sure, why not? Betrayal. Okay, let's go. Well, get a little horned and, you know, take old camel on these old dang old inner eye, man. You know, lots of shots, man. Old worm buddy! Old dang old goat, man. You know, love the goat, man. dang old guppy's head, man. You know, heartbreak and, you know, sanguine bond. Don't even take that item, man. I'm still going to take it on this little dang old run here. No seraphim. Dull Razor, yep. Yep. Black hole, son. Won't you come? Wash away the rain, black hole, son. Won't you come? Won't you come? Won't you come? Oh, God. Stuttering. Don't admit. Yeah. Okay. I'm going to just go ahead and boost that old dangle back up there. All right. Good. Yep. All right. I do not want cursed eye. So. $0.99. What a ripoff. What a ripoff. If we get to 700 likes, I'll buy Arky and do it all over again. But you got to do it before the end of this floor, which better be quick. Yep. All right. Good. Got it. Yep. All right. Yep. All right. Yep. All right. Good. Oh, no. Need 10 left. I'm heading out the door. Heading out. I'm going to look for the secret room real quick. Buy you some time. Is it? I give up. They make it? They made it! Mamma mia. Hello, Johannes. Thank you, everybody. Oh, yeah, I guess it could have been the left of the last room. Whatever. Look, it's mid-orb. How many hours do I have in Isaac? A lot. Card baby. Okay. Good. Yep. Yep. Oh, Lord. Okay. All right. Got it. Good. Awesome. Killer. Radical. All right. Pulse PhD. Oh, God. All right, good. Yep. 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 Oh, we're breakfast. We have been breakfasted. All right, good. Yep. Okay. All right. Oh, gee. All right. I think we're going to be okay here. Just, go ahead and, check this out real quick right here. They gotta make it to a Pokemon stream. Alright. Only 286 more likes, everybody. And I'll go for another hour and a half. Sounds like a lot, but it's really not. I'm not, like, I fired once in this room. 1,000 likes and I re-roll the whole build? Sure. 1,000 likes and I'll re-roll on the Arky. And also go until 8:30. I don't anticipate greed lasting very long. Only 665. Or 665. 265, I mean. All right. Here we go. Good luck, Greed. Yep. And it broke. Had a 20% chance to break, by the way. Go ahead and... Ooh. Hmm. I wonder what that's gonna look like. Get Athame? Oh god. Okay. Remember, we've already been breakfasted, so... Oh! Well. Oh, God. 1,000 likes and we use Genesis. What does this run, dude? All right, good. Yep. Yep. All right. Oh my God. Holy mantle. All right. Okay. We're at 751 right now. If we get to 1K, we'll go until 8:30, which is another hour and 3 minutes. And I'll re-roll this run. With Genesis. There is no more items. It's 12:27 PM in Australia. Bonza. Air crack of the whip, mate. Yep. Okay. Hey, that works. Thank Rune. Soul of peace, aw. A C-section does allow you to see. That is true. I guess why that that's they call it C-section. Hello, LeBron. Hello, up next. Ow. Oh! Runs pretty good. No! Oh, Mac Daddy. Oh, my Lord in heaven. Yep. Things are dying before they're spawned. Oh! Bro. Bro. Hello, Sly Guy. Wow, that's a long time, Sly Guy. Yeah. I was watching Frag today, actually. D-Sizzle. Oh my god. No! Well, I don't think Polyphemus would have done too much. Oh my Lord. Okay. Alright. Binge Eater. Binge Eater. Or Cancer. Binge Eater. I don't know what that is, but Binge Eater. All the Void doesn't matter. Sulfur, Binge Eater, and Binge Eater. Then go ahead and go with Binge Eater. And give me some of that Binge Eater. Go with a Binge Eater. Purity, yeah, I would take Purity all day, every day. Binge Eater. And a Binge Eater. Infestation 2, Hive Mind, yeah. Yeah, that's going to be a Binge Eater. All right. I think it's good. All right. All right. We are 238 away from me Genesising. Got to happen before the end of this run, though. I have no keys somehow. Sure. Compound fracture. Let's just actually break the game. Oh, that's right. We used a black rune. Dumpy. Oh my Lord. We take Capricorn. Binge Eater. And Wafer. Oh, that will break the game. Thank you, Roy, for the 3-month resub. Lusty Blood. No, I'm going to go with Binge Eater. Right, baby. Okay. Let's see what this looks like, shall we? Well, I mean, Binge Eater. Hello, Shoo Shoo. Yep. Immediate crash. Immediately crashed. Woo! Yeah, Tech Zero, not gonna happen. Can't do Tech Zero, unfortunately. Stompy! Yep. Yep. Oh, apparently he's bloated again. Oh my god. Deadeye. Binge Eater. And Binge Eater. Woohoo. Yo, we got the creep. Quaz.
Devil card.
Salvation, and I think Brittle Bones. Sure. I have no keys. Oh, it's just Compound Fracture again. Binge Eater. I can't even charge up Maw of the Void in time before everything just dies. Yep. Alright, good. Yeah, I'm not gonna take Jacob's Ladder. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna show people. So, all right. So, there was someone on YouTube who claims that I edited a run wrong because they heard a hard break in the music. They're like, "Oh, you did a bad edit there. You should have clipped it better." And in actuality, since Repentance came out, they audio mixed the sound that you hear right now poorly, and you'll hear the cut. So just wait for it, because this was this guy's justification that, oh, Sinvicta edits all of his runs. Yeah, okay. You gotta wait for it though. They didn't mix this track that you hear right now properly, and there's a very hard cut. Yeah, I think I talked over it. I'll turn the music up. Right there. So I made the joke on Twitch. I was like, oh yeah, I gotta improve my live editing. I gotta improve my on-demand live editing. How dare I miss that cut? Oh man, this. I can't even charge Sumptorium fast enough. I mean, yeah, like everybody knows that there's a hard cut right there. How do you tell if a penny is lucky? You see the green outline on it, the green tinge. I almost want to reroll for a full charge just so I can use some thorium. Oh my god. You'll see a little green highlight on the penny. What's this? Joker. All right. All right. Here we go. Last chance, everyone. Where are we at? We're at 779. We need 221. 221. I'm not sure if the mosh pit's going to make it. Uh-oh. Wait, we haven't crashed. We haven't crashed yet. I'm hitting continuum is the problem. It also might be the Claudies. We're down to 212. I think that's an Alt F4 here, because it is super hard locked. I'm pretty sure it's the Claudies and Continuum. I can't even... Oh, there it goes. I can't even Alt F4 that one. Nah, I didn't go through the task manager. Okay, so I probably need to remove Continuum. It could also be a Thame, but I'm pretty sure it was Continuum. I have no idea what just hit me. I don't even know what's going on anymore. All right. Oh. Well. It didn't do anything. Yeah, Thame didn't really do anything.
Soul of Judas.
Oh my god, what is happening? What is that blinking? All right. Binge Eater. I don't even know what that's going to look like, but we're going to find out. Hey, it's Lusty Bud again. Binge Eater. School bag. Binge Eater. And a Binge Eater. Or blue map. Thank you, Eucharist. All right. I think that's GG, Mosh Pit. I don't even have to fire to do anything. But I'm gonna. This might also crash the game. Oh my god, what was that? All right. Yep. That was instant death. That was instant death. Well, there you go. Need some techno music. Now, there's no reason to Genesis at this point. I mean, the run's over. We would have to Genesis into an R key. But I think that's good. It's almost 8 o'clock here. I need to eat, so. Oh, boy. Thank you for watching, everybody. Thank you for all the support. We almost hit 800 likes tonight. A lot of fun. Thanks for hanging around after the raid stuff. Thanks for everyone who showed up to the raid part of the stream. Subscribe if you're not already, everyone. Happy New Year. Merry Christmas. Happy Holidays. And, yeah, I really appreciate all the support, everyone. We'll be back on Twitch tomorrow for Pokemon Breaks and Isaac and all kinds of fun stuff, maybe even some Lethal Company and Project Zomboid. So until next time, keep it metal and be cool to each other. That's all I've got for tonight, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Have a great holiday, good weekend, and Happy New Year. Until then, good night, everybody.